Hello, in this video, I will discuss about the signal conditioning. Signal conditioning circuits are employed in instrumentation system, and the performance of the entire system can be affected by the behavior of any of the signal conditioning circuit. The signal conditioning circuit provides means to convert various forms of sensor output into letter signal, signal amplification, noise rejection, and so on. Most of the commercially available sensor consists of built-in signal conditioning circuit. Here I show some of the signal conditioning system. The first one is a conversion into electrical signal. Because all of the sensor output is the physical property, our control system, automation system, need the electrical property. So we need the conversion from signal physical property to electrical signal. Mostly we use the Wheaton bridge, linear potentiometer, or LVDT. This electrical signal is would be the very low to use for the control system or other application. At the time we need to do signal amplification, we have to use the amplifier. After the amplification, the amplifier output signal may not be the purifying signal, including the noise signal. So we need to reject this noise signal by using the filter. Sometimes the system, automation system, need the digital signal. All of the sensor output is the analog signal. Even after the amplification, after the noise rejection, until this stage, the output signal is the analog signal. So we need to convert to digital signal. At the time we will use analog to digital conversion, ADC. Okay, let's see the first signal conditioning circuit, bridge circuit, that is widely used for the conversion from physical property to electrical property. Because this improvement, this can be improve the measurement of the accuracy by using the bridge circuit. Bridge circuit have the three type: resistance bridge, capacitance bridge, and inductance bridge. Okay, in this video I will discuss on the resistance bridge. This is a standard bridge circuit, also called the Wheaton bridge. This type of bridge circuit is widely used in precision measurement of resistance from 1 ohm to 10 power 6 ohm. Actually, the bridge circuit has a 2 amp as shown in this figure. Each amp has a 2 parallel circuit, a 2 parallel resistor, R1, R4, R2 and R3, R1, R4 parallel, R2, R3 parallel. So this is the bridge circuit equivalent circuit of the bridge. Okay, let's analyze this bridge circuit. For the bridge circuit, when we analyze the bridge circuit, bridge circuit will have the two condition: balance condition and unbalanced condition. Okay, let's see the first on balance condition. What is the balance condition? What is the balance condition? We have noted that it may be the possible to get the fresh output is a 0 Vout may be the 0 Vout, but it only happens under the certain condition. When the bridge output voltage is 0, it is said to be the balanced bridge. Okay, let's see the balanced bridge analysis. Okay, let's analyze on the Wheatstone bridge. Now, from this figure, where to find the first, we'll find the Vout. Okay, first we'll find the Vout. Vout Vout equal to VAB minus VAD. Okay, VAB equal to R1 plus R2 VS. VAD equal to R4 plus R4 VS. When you substitute to here, R1 plus R2 VS minus R4 plus R4 VS equal to Vout. And now in this case, we are consider the bridge as the balance, therefore Vout equal to 0. So R1 plus R2 VS equal to R4 plus R4 VS. In here, VS is a common factor, so we can remove R1 plus R2 equal to R4 plus R4. So we'll do the cross multiplication. R1 R3 plus R1 R4 equal to R1 R4 plus R2 R4. Here R1 R4 is a common, so we take out R1 R3 equal to R2 R4. Therefore R1 over R2 equal to R4 over R3. So we got that R1 over R2 equal to R4 over R3. And also we can write R3 or R2. If you want to find the R3, there is simply R2 R4 over R1. Okay, now we can find R1 over R2 equal to R2 over R4 over R3. So the main equation is this equation. For the balance condition, if R1, R2, R3, R4 are sequentially around this like this, R1, R3 equal to R1, R3 equal to R3, R2, R4. Okay, after we discuss the balance bridge, we also need to analyze the unbalanced bridge. There is not too much difference between the balance and unbalanced bridge. The difference only at the Vout. Because at the balance bridge, the Vout is the 0, but an unbalanced bridge, the Vout is not 0. So where to find the Vout? To find the Vout, similarly the previous one, Vout equal to VAB minus VAD. VAB minus VAD. But at the balance bridge, Vout is 0. Therefore, VAB minus VAD equal to 0. But in the unbalanced bridge, Vout is not the 0. Therefore, VAB minus VAD, we have to find this by using this. We can find Vout by using this equation. Okay, let's go to the, okay, there's the analysis of the bridge circuit. The next one is the amplifier. What's the amplifier? Why we need to use the amplifier for the instrumentation system? Actually, the amplifier is to increase the amplitude of the signal. We have to use the amplifier. Okay, an amplifier is one of the most important components in an instrumentation system. We use every system to increase the low level signal from a transducer, from a sensor, to a high level signal for recording with a voltage measurement instrument. Because the output from the sensor may be the lower than the requirement input for the control system, automation system. The sensor output signal is the input signal to the automation system, control system. So when we need to amplify this sensor output signal to get the sufficiently high signal for the control system. So we are using the amplifier. So the function of the amplifier is to operate the sensor to magnify the weak signal and also to operate the control system and etc. But sometimes the gain from the signal amplifier is not enough. Other than we have to use two or more amplifier can be series connected. That's called the cascade condition. But what is the gain? Well, before we discuss about the gain, we have to see the amplifier. Well, only commonly used type of the amplifier is the operational amplifier as shown in this figure. Operational amplifier have different input, inverting input and non-inverting input. The low signal Vi is a differential voltage on the input side. A higher output Vr is a output voltage V or V out on the output sides. So we can find the gain, also called the degree of amplification. So the degree of the amplification is the output over input, V out over Vi. This also called the gain. This gain is a of the amplifier. The gain of this amplifier is to set the voltage for between the lower and upper limit. For example, negative 10 volt to positive 10 volt. Sometimes the gain from a single amplifier is not enough. That I want to use there. Two or more amplifier can be connected in series. For all of the amplifier, operational amplifier, maybe inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier, we can classify into two types. We call the operational amplifier as the two input, inverting input and non-inverting input. When the input signal is connected to the negative input, we can say this is an inverting amplifier. And also the input signal is connected to the positive input, we have to say as the non-inverting amplifier. So the gain from these two amplifiers is different. Let's see the inverting amplifier. Inverting amplifier is the input signal is connected to the negative input. Okay, now the input signal is connected to the negative input. Here resistor RF, feedback resistor RF used as a feedback to the output to the inverting input. And also we'll use the R1 connect to the input voltage to the same point. So this is a common connection. Common connection is equal to the summing point. So when we assume the infinite impedance, IS equal to 0. IS equal to, at the summing point, current is at 0. Therefore, I1 plus IF equal to 0. I1 plus IF equal to IS, summing amplifier, summing current. But IS equal to, we assume IS equal to 0. Therefore, I1 plus IF equal to 0. For the I1, V equal to IR. Therefore, for the I1, VI over R1. And also for the IF, V out over RF. Okay. To find the gain equal to V out over V in. Therefore, we see VI R1 equal to negative V out over RF. So when we do V out over VI, RF over R1, negative RF over R1. V out over VI is a gain. Therefore, gain equal to negative RF over R1. Most of the operational amplifier circuit use the negative feedback. Okay, biasa bame. Okay, the amplifier can classify into two type: inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier. Because the operational amplifier has two input: inverting input and non-inverting input. When the input signal is connected to the negative input, that is the inverting amplifier. When the input signal is connected to the positive input, that is a non-inverting amplifier. Okay, let's see the inverting amplifier. At the inverting amplifier, the input signal is connected to the negative input. We'll use RF as the output to the inverting. And also we are using the R1. Connect input voltage VI to the same point from the RF. Therefore, the common connection equal to the summing point. When we assume the infinite impedance IS equal to 0, therefore the current at the summing point IS equal to I1 plus IF. Because of the high impedance, we assume IS equal to 0. I1 plus IF. For the I1, V equal to IR, therefore I equal to V over R. To find the I1, VI over RI, VI over R1. For the IF, V out over RF equal to 0. Therefore V out over RF equal to negative VI over R1. Therefore, V out over VI equal to negative RF over R1. V out over VI is a gain. Therefore, gain equal to negative RF over RF. Therefore, the gain for the inverting amplifier is a negative RF over. Okay, for the non-inverting amplifier, as shown in this figure, the input signal is connected to the positive input. And also RF and R1, R2 are connected as shown in the figure. Similar to the inverted amplifier, the summing point current IS equal to I1 plus IF. Therefore, I1 plus IF equal to, okay, at the non-inverting amplifier, at the summing point, IS equal to I1 plus IF. We assume IS 0 because of the high impedance, I1 plus IF. For the I1, at the I1 equal to VI over R1 plus IF equal to VI minus V out over RF. Therefore, 0 equal to VI over R1 plus VI over RF minus V out over RF. Therefore, V out over RF equal to VI over R1 plus VI over RF equal to VI 1 over R1 plus 1 over RF. Therefore, V out over VI, V out divided VI equal to RF multiplying with the 1 over R1 plus 1 over RF. Therefore, equal to RF over R1 plus RF over RF equal to RF over R1 plus 1, because RF over RF, therefore this is 1. V out over VI equal to gain, therefore gain equal to 1 plus RF over R1. So the gain for non-inverting amplifier is a 1 plus RF over R1. So that is a difference. For the non-inverting amplifier is a positive gain, and gain for the inverting amplifier is a negative gain. That's the difference between inverting and non-inverting amplifier gain. We can also modify the inverting amplifier because the input will be the more than one input. After that, we have to use the summing amplifier. So this is a modification of the inverting amplifier. The input will be the more than one input. Add two or more applying voltage at the inverting input. So signal from two or more sources must be added to obtain the output signal. The output signal is the proportion to the sum of the input signal. So the output voltage Vout equal to negative RF by the sum of the VN over RN. So this is a summing amplifier. Another one is a current to voltage converter. At the receiving end of the measurement signal, transmission signal system need to convert the current back to the into the voltage. At the time we have to use the this type of the circuit, just simply at the two resistor. This is a feedback resistor. Input source is a current, so the signal from the transducer, still it is combined with the noise. So we need to amplify, so we need to filter out this noise. What is the effect of noise? If you did not filter out this noise, that will reduce the accuracy of the measurement, and also that introduce a distortion in sound signal. For the control system, the noise will introduce the error, so your control system may not get the correct signal. For our control system, it's very important to filter out the noise that is called the unwanted signal. To eliminate the noise, how we can eliminate to reduce the undesirable effect of the noise? How we will do? We can do three ways. The first one is the grounding or shading of the electrical connection. That's very simple. And also we have to do the averaging several measurements. But this is not too much practical for our control system, because I will use the automation control system. So the noise also need to filter out automatically. So we have to use the filtering. That's called the smoothing. We have to use the filter circuit. But even you filtering, that will not solve all the problem. But it does provide a significant degree of the our experiment. Okay, filter can be classified into three types: low pass filter, bandpass filter, and high pass filter. Okay, what is the difference between these three? For the low pass filter, that passes the signal with the frequency lower than the certain cutoff frequency. That means reject the signal with the frequency higher than the cutoff frequency, FC. FC is the cutoff frequency. For the high pass filter, that filter passes signal with the frequency higher than the certain cutoff frequency. That means reject signal with the frequency lower than the cutoff frequency. That is inversely between the high pass and low pass. High pass reject the signal lower than cutoff frequency. Band pass, low pass reject the frequency when the frequency is higher than the cutoff frequency. For the high pass, the frequency that allows the pass of the signal with the when the frequency lower than the cutoff the frequency. For the high pass, that allows to pass the signal with the frequency higher than the certain cutoff frequency. Bandpass is the combine of these two, low pass and high pass. Bandpass filter that passes frequency within the certain limit, certain range, within the range, and reject the frequency out of the range. That is the difference between three type of the. All the filter can be constructed by using resistor, capacitor, and resistor inductor. So they are called by RL, RC filter. When you use the resistor and capacitor, that is called the RC filter. When you use the resistor and inductor, that is called the RL filter. Just we use this for the circuit. For the low pass, we can construct in two ways, RC filter or RL low pass, and also for the high pass we can use RC high pass filter or RL high pass filter. Just the difference, you can see the difference in this figure. Okay, let's see this example. Compute the voltage gain and then output voltage for the inverting operational amplifier circuit. So we must use the inverting operational amplifier circuit. Given that Vin input voltage 1 millivolt, feedback resistor 120 kilo ohm, and R1 equal to 20 kilo ohm. Okay, let's see how we calculate this one. We must use the inverting amplifier. The given Vin equal to 1 millivolt, RF equal to 120 kilo ohm, and also R1 equal to 20 kilo ohm. Therefore, to find the gain and V out. Okay, for the inverting amplifier gain, equal to negative RF over R1, therefore equal to negative 120 kilo ohm over 20 kilo ohm. We got the negative 6. Now we got the gain. After you got the gain, because the gain equal to V out over V in equal to negative 6. V in is the 1 millivolt. V out over 1 millivolt equal to negative 6. Therefore, we can get the V out equal to negative 6 millivolt. This is a very simple. Okay, thank you very much.